Welcome to the What Works Clearinghouse Single Case Design Standards Training, focused on introducing the logic of single case designs. You can find more information about the WWC in general at the WWC website, whatworks.ed.gov. This module broadly defines single case designs, describes some common single case design variations that the WWC reviews, and finally, it will cover how to assess whether a study is eligible for review as a single case design. After completing this module, you will be familiar with some common single case design variations and be able to identify whether a study is eligible for WWC review as a single case design. Single case designs, also sometimes called single case experimental designs or single subject designs, are experimental designs that have the goal of assessing whether there is a causal relationship between some intervention and an outcome. These designs are a form of interrupted time series designs and can provide rigorous experimental evaluations of intervention effects. Single case designs are typically characterized by individual cases as the unit of intervention application and data analysis. Cases are observed repeatedly across time in a series, with observations generally broken into phases, typically one or more baseline phases prior to or in the absence of treatment, followed by one or more treatment phases. Throughout these modules, we will present a number of examples in plotted form. In applied practice, single case designs heavily depend on plots for assessing study quality and demonstrating study results. Early on in these modules, you will see many plots where different conditions have different colors and shapes. We have done this to assist trainees unfamiliar with these studies. In practice, most single case design studies use black and white plots where the shape of the point corresponds to different outcomes. As these modules progress, we will transition to black and white plots that are more closely aligned with what you are likely to see in practice when reviewing single case design studies. The plot we present here is an example of an AB design. The baseline phase corresponds to the A phase, and the intervention phase is the B phase. This design has weak internal validity because events other than the intervention, such as those related to maturation or history, could be the true cause of the intervention effect. A student may have reached a developmental milestone at the same time as the onset of the intervention, or there may have been some change in the classroom that could have had an impact on the outcome. Researchers use elaborations on this basic AB design, which allow for the replication of the intervention effects within cases, across cases, or both. Single case designs are common in educational and psychological research, particularly in contexts where the interventions are carefully tailored to the particular needs of the target population. Single case designs are also common for research where the population of interest is low prevalence, making it difficult to obtain enough participants for a between group design. Single case designs can also be useful in contexts where a true control condition in a between group design may be difficult or unethical to implement. Single case designs are often used in practice to evaluate intervention effects relative to a no intervention baseline phase, or to compare the relative effectiveness of two or more interventions intended to have an impact in similar populations or contexts. Now let's discuss some common single case design variations that you are likely to see during reviews of single case designs for the WWC. Under version 5.0 of the WWC Procedures and Standards Handbook, the WWC has explicit standards for the review of four types of single case designs. These designs are the treatment reversal or treatment withdrawal design, the changing criterion design, the multiple baseline or multiple probe design, and the alternating treatment design. Each of these designs allow for effect replication at multiple points in time. As we will discuss later in this module, the current understanding among applied single case design researchers is that a study shows intervention effectiveness when the design can document at least three separate demonstrations of an experimental effect at three different points in time, either within a single case or across different cases. The first design we will discuss is the treatment reversal or withdrawal design. The treatment reversal or withdrawal design is characterized by alternating phases without and with the intervention of interest. This design is also sometimes called an ABK design, where K represents the number of phase pairs. On the right, we present a typical treatment reversal design, which is an example of an ABAB design. It begins with a baseline phase, the first A phase, followed by a treatment phase, or the first B phase. The transition between the first baseline phase and the first treatment phase represents the first opportunity to demonstrate an intervention effect. The first intervention phase is followed by a phase where the intervention is withdrawn. This is another phase in the baseline condition, sometimes called the return to baseline phase, or the second A phase. The transition between the first treatment phase and the return to baseline phase represents the second opportunity to demonstrate an intervention effect. Finally, there is another treatment phase, which can be referred to as the second B phase. The transition between the return to baseline phase and the second intervention phase is the third and final opportunity to demonstrate an intervention effect. By observing three similar changes as a consequence of the presence or absence of treatment, researchers can have greater certainty that the change is in response to treatment, as opposed to a consequence of history or maturation. Because this design involves the repeated application and then withdrawal of treatment, the design is only appropriate when the intervention effect can reverse or decay after it is withdrawn. This is sometimes referred to as an outcome or intervention being reversible. In version 5.0 of the handbook, the WWC has added a step to assess the presence or absence of reversibility for findings that are potentially eligible to receive a research rating of meets WWC standards without reservations, which we will discuss later on in this module. We want to highlight two important details about this type of design before moving on. First, not all treatment reversal designs will begin with a baseline phase. For instance, to allow for comparisons within and across cases, studies with multiple cases being studied under treatment reversal designs may alternate phase ordering so that half the cases are undergoing the intervention while the other half are in a baseline or return to baseline phase. The second note to highlight is that this design allows for as many phases as the researcher desires. A four-phase treatment reversal design, as shown here, is simply the smallest number of phases, which allow for three opportunities to demonstrate an intervention effect. Some treatment reversal designs reported in the literature may use more than the four phases shown in this simple example. The next single case design we will discuss is the changing criterion design. This design is characterized by multiple intervention phases for an intervention intended to change the outcome in a stepwise fashion. Successive intervention phases are applied after the outcome reaches some pre-specified criterion value or criterion range. Such pre-specified criteria might, for instance, be that a student's percentage of time on tasks exceeds 20% for 5 sessions, then exceeds 50%, and finally exceeds 60%. Some designs will also include embedded reversals to baseline in addition to the steadily incrementing criterion. As with the treatment reversal design shown previously, there are three opportunities to demonstrate an intervention effect in the example changing criterion design shown here. Once between the initial baseline and the first intervention phase, next followed by the transition between the first intervention phase and the second intervention phase, and then finally between the second and third intervention phase. The next design we will discuss is the multiple baseline design. Multiple baseline designs are characterized by multiple cases entering the baseline phase at similar times, and then the intervention is introduced at times that are staggered across cases. This design allows for three intervention effects to be observed at the staggered introduction of the intervention. Additionally, the design also allows for comparison across the baseline phases. For instance, if the other baseline phases demonstrated changes in the direction of the intervention effect when the first case received the intervention, this is potential evidence that the observed change in the first case is due to some shared effect of history or maturation rather than the intervention. If the cases still in baselines do not change when one case receives the intervention, we can have more confidence that changes in the outcome are due to the intervention. The same effect of history or maturation is unlikely to have occurred at three different times for three different cases. Each row in the plot can be generically referred to as a tier, which often corresponds to a case within the design. In the multiple baseline design, cases can be multiple participants with the same behavior in similar contexts. An example of this multiple baseline across participants design is shown in the plot on the right, which presents data from three different participants. But the multiple baseline design can also be used to examine the intervention effect in different contexts for the same behaviors, or different behaviors for the same unit. An example of such a multiple baseline design across contexts is shown in the new plot on the right, where the same outcome is being observed in three different contexts. The multiple probe design is a variation of the multiple baseline design. It is differentiated from the multiple baseline design by intermittent rather than continuous data collection probes. It is important to note that the intermittent data collection in a multiple probe design is a planned feature of the design. Missing data sometimes happen in any single case design, due to classroom absences or other uncontrollable factors. However, the presence of a few points of missing data does not make a multiple baseline design a multiple probe design. Rather, multiple probe designs are commonly used when continuous testing of a behavior or skill which has not yet been learned could be considered harmful or costly for the participant. So the researchers intentionally plan to collect baseline data at the minimum amount necessary to establish an ongoing pattern of behavior. The final single case design we will discuss is the alternating treatment design. This design is characterized by the rapid switching between two or more treatment conditions. These designs have quick phases of only a few observations. The reason for rapid alteration is that there is some concern that repeated testing might lead to carryover between conditions. In these designs, effect replication occurs at each transition between treatments. There are a handful of ways this design might appear different from other single case designs. Unlike other designs, alternating treatment designs do not always have a baseline or business as usual phase. Additionally, the sequential observations from an individual treatment are connected to each other, rather than the first observation being connected to the second observation, the third observation being connected to the fourth, and so on. The reason for this is that the traditional form of analysis for single case designs is visual analysis, where researchers visually compare the two or more treatments. Connecting the observations in the manner shown on this plot facilitates the comparison of the two treatments. Although we have only discussed the four total designs in our overview of single case designs, there are other kinds of single case designs used by researchers. Some of these designs combine elements of two or more designs called combination designs, and we will discuss how to review those designs in more detail in Module 4 of the training. However, researchers continue to develop novel types of single case designs. To review a study that uses a different type of single case design not explicitly described in the handbook, review team leadership must document published professional conventions for what constitutes a high quality type of the novel design. For the design to be able to meet WWC's standards, the design must contain at least 3 attempts to demonstrate the intervention effect at 3 different points in time. Additionally, these novel designs must also meet the general eligibility requirements for the SCDs described in the next chapter of this module.